Good morning, church. It's Monday morning, and take your Bibles and let's go to Revelation chapter number 21 as we look at some of the last verses in that chapter. And chapter 21 and verse number 22, it says, "But I saw no temple in it." Now, no temple in that New Jerusalem. Remember, we were talking about the New Jerusalem yesterday in this beautiful place, and there's not going to be any temple there. There's no place to worship. Why? Because the entire place is the temple of God. We are the temple of God. God's going to always be with us. Everywhere we're at, Jesus is in our hearts, and so we can worship wherever, but there's no temple to go to. Now, in the earthly Jerusalem, there's going to be a temple during the millennial reign, and people will come to that temple. They'll be even making sacrifices, and there'll be certain things and rituals that take place at that temple on the earth, but that's for people in these human bodies that have not yet been glorified. For us that are glorified, we're living in a new Jerusalem, and there's no need for a temple, it says. It tells us why. For the Lamb, or the Lord God Almighty, and the Lamb are its temple. So we're going to always worship. We're going to be in God, and wherever we're at, we're in God's temple, in God's presence. Now notice this, it says in verse 23, "The city had no need for the sun or the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God illuminated it. The Lamb is its light." Remember, I talked about all these beautiful 12 stones. We talked about the pearls. We talked about the gold, all this crystal. It's just going to be God's glory shining in this place. There's never darkness. There's no night, no need for us to sleep. Now, we can lay down and sleep if we want to, but there's really no need for some of those things. And it's just going to be a glorious, glorious picture of marvelous glorification of God. Just seeing Him, His Shekinah glory, as God illuminates this place. Jesus truly is the light of the world. "And the nations of those who are saved shall walk in its light, and the kings of the earth shall bring their glory and honor into it." So they'll be allowed to come, only the saved, from time to time. Now he's talking about those not yet in their glorified bodies. It's the kings of the earth will get to come into it. "Its gates shall not be shut at all by day," nor there's not going to be any night there, he says in verse 25. So the gates are not going to be shut. In other words, it's not going to be a city that's going to have to be defended, that we're going to have to worry about someone's always attacking. It's going to be that Jerusalem that's the Jerusalem on the earth has been attacked many times. They're always worried and concerned about a siege and being destroyed, but not that city. It doesn't even have to be locked up. "And they shall bring the glory and the honor of the nations into it, but there shall be by no means enter anything that defiles or causes an abomination or lie, but only those things, those who are written in the Lamb's Book of Life." So again, it's only the saved who have right to that city. Some say, well, the people on the earth aren't going to have right to that city during the millennial reign, only us and our redeemed bodies. I can live with that. If he's talking about the kings of the earth being us, then we're ruling and reigning and so forth. But I think from time to time, even the saved who are still in their physical bodies, who have not yet gone through death and glorification, that some of them will be brought into that kingdom and get to see that, and they'll go back to their nations and they'll go back to their people and describe the beauty of that. But no one who has any sin is going to be in that city. No abomination, no sin. Only those whose blood, whose lives are covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, whose blood covers our sins and our names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. It's going to be a wonderful day. I hope you're there. Get prepared because Jesus is coming soon. Let us pray. Father, we thank you that we have again the sure promise of a place prepared for us. Oh, what a wonderful city this has been described. What an amazing carpenter our Lord is, that he is a master carpenter with all the things that he needs in life, all the lumber, all the gold, all the tinsels, all the things that he needs. He can make us such a beautiful place to live. What a wonderful husband he is, that he would make for his bride a place like this. And we want to be a part of that. And we bless you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.